Yes, she actually, and we do indeed, we had three Oscars in the Oscar nominations, Best Screenplay in the last 3 years. Two of them won the Oscar. The one who didn't, it was his second nomination, a third nomination would have been a second Oscar, and 10 projects for Steven Spielberg, and on and on and on. What I refer to in the book in that instance with Who's the Boss, it's a ratty little old TV sitcom. She actually specced an episode of a similar sitcom. Mm-hmm. Her agent, she was able to win representation. And that agent sent her over to pitch Who's the Boss. And she had a number of ideas that she pitched to them. They loved them all, but they said, we're not going to do any of those. We have our own notion in mind. And that's what they gave her to write. That was her first professional assignment in television.
But in writing it, she did something different because it had to do with friendship and Tony's daughter. And he said, well, I had a good friend that the friendship
right.
broke. And she did an interesting thing of bringing a character in. He's going to become friends again. And then the man takes off his jacket, and it turns out he has become a priest.
He's a priest. When we meet him, and it's a perfect example, again, of the small screen, but big action emotionally. He suddenly, he's meeting up with this kid who was a down and dirty, you know, street fighting kind of youth. Whom he had fallen out with. The daughter had fallen out with a friend of hers, and he was saying you should reconcile, and she says, why don't you reconcile with your old pal? So he's shamed into it, and when the guy reappears after years they've been apart, he's wearing a priest's collar, and that's a wonderful reveal all by itself. Of course, he then they reminisce and they have great old times, but then an argument arises left over from years ago in the old neighborhood. And the priest ends up cold cocking him. He actually punches him in the face, knocks him to the ground. And then he's so ashamed that he did this that he decides that he really shouldn't be a priest, that he never got the calling from God. And he renounces the priesthood. And Tony feels responsible for the fact that...
Dissolution,
You know, so there are some really, really profound issues that arise in the context of a very, some would say superficial, some would say superfluous sitcom. A smart writer is able to make articulate and engaging insights into some really, really important human issues. In this instance, faith, the nature of faith, that faith isn't really faith unless it's challenged, and that a challenge to a faith is a good thing. It makes it strong, and it's amazing to get that into 24 television minutes in Who's the Boss with Tony Danza, of all things.
Richard, there is a story, too, of you have a student who has written a screenplay or a script, and you go take a meeting, and the producer or the man who's putting the money up says to the writer, listen, I'd like him to be stronger. And a great story.
Yeah, well, the writer suddenly panics. I mean, this was a deal where I was involved even as a producer. He had been it was a former student, so there was no, I had no authority over him any longer as a student. I couldn't really work professionally that way with somebody who was currently enrolled in our program. He had graduated some years ago. He had a brilliant, brilliant notion that he had pitched. I had taken it to... actually to Bernie Brillstein, rest his soul, a very prominent and intelligent producer. All they wanted to do was go through the motions of a little meeting and then go off and let him go off and write the thing. I would merely supervise as a kind of a story editor. The heavy lifting had to be done by the writer. And as we were leaving, he says, Bernie does to the writer, and I remember, make him strong, you understand what we mean? And the writer, for some reason, very self-destructively, very neurotically, starts to panic and says, well, what do you mean? He says, well, you don't know what strong means? Firm, decisive, willful. He starts to go through the thesaurus. And as he does, this guy goes into a panic, and suddenly I could see that this whole project is going south. So I said, you know what, Bernie, let me go out with the writer and let's come back, reschedule tomorrow, and we'll finish up tomorrow. And I took him to the parking lot and I said, now tomorrow, you don't say anything unless I do all the talking, and you're allowed to speak if I do this, if I give you this signal with my ear. And if you're asked any questions, you understand, you to nod your head and say yes. They won't even remember this meeting 2 minutes after we walk out of there.
You know, Richard, there are such great things in here, even about for what a time lock is, exposition, the middles, what do you do in the middles, and the fact that if you do submit a screenplay, don't make it 180 pages.
Very important. First thing a reader does, when you submit a screenplay to an agent or a producer, he or she is going to give it to a reader who is going to read it and prepare what they call coverage, a short report describing it so that the producer doesn't have to read it and get an idea of what it's about. I mean, they just can't read all the material that comes to them. And the first thing that she looks at the reader is the length of that script. And if it's 103 pages, she likes that script already. Now, that may change when she reads the script. But if you're looking at 100 and, even 124 pages, never mind 136, 182, it's like neon flashing saying, amateur, amateur.
The same way, it better be typed in Courier New 12-point.
Yeah, well, of course, it can be done on a word processor, but it should happen in that script on the page that can't happen on a typewriter. Otherwise, people should not use boldface and centering and right margin justification and other computer tricks, italices and stuff like that. It looks as if the language is not enough. It needs to be illustrated somehow, almost as if you put pictures in the script, which just is not professional.
And the person who's sitting down to write a screenplay, make an outline. It is professional to have an outline and know where you're going, even if you have just the cards.
Quite so. It doesn't matter if the outline is on a number of pages or on cards. Cards are kind of fun because you can rearrange them easily. It's fun to work with cards. It can be quite liberating as a writer in terms of finding your structure. Yes, you need an outline, you need a plan, but then you also have to let go of that plan, abandon that plan as you move through it, because there will ultimately, inevitably, there will be surprises. And the important, I've never known a writer who wasn't surprised by a twist and a turn in the plot, by a line of dialogue that the character spoke. And the important thing for writers is to stay open to those changes and not try to haul it back to that outline.
Or I believe it was your mother who said, when in doubt, throw it out.
Well, it was actually the Department of Agriculture talking about